Hello again, Minecrafters of YouTube, and welcome back to another episode of Feed the Beast Infinity Skyblock. This time with me, Black, and no, White, unfortunately. She's on that bachelorette party she talked about on the last episode. But as you can see, I've done some progress on this roof here. Still no jetpack. but we're getting closer every episode. And I was thinking, since when I speak with White, my speech is more fluent, so this episode I was planning on doing more technical progress than actual speaking for the funds. But this house, so far I'm quite happy with it, and I've also done some progress on this house over here. I'll show you the blue stained glass panes stuff that I put down. I decided to remove the pink glowstone as well, because even though pink is a beautiful color, I didn't think it blended in here. This is chisel stained glass panes, and this blue color is it's gorgeous. And I've done some more, started working on the walls inside on the bottom floor as well. The floor itself, I have no clue what you do with. Probably put down some type of carpet, because carpets are awesome. And there's one thing I wanted to clarify with this here. I was a bit vague or incorrect in placing this chest here in the end of the last episode. The harvester, of course, auto outputs into the pipe on the bottom. So that's that. One thing I want to craft while I have you here, because if you look in this building, I've done quite a lot. I'm quite proud of myself. I placed down an LV capacitor bank here. There's 9 capacitors here, so that's 900,000 RF. That goes to constantly power the powered lanterns, and there's always power for the presses when we do several gears or plates at once. This is coming along quite good. If I only had a jetpack, it would come along quite gooder. But we're not there yet. But speaking of a capacitor bank, we want to make an Ender.io capacitor bank to store all of our power. So, to make a capacitor bank, as always, when we do something, we do it proper, as White says, and we do it once. So we do the vibrant capacitor bank, for starters. Oh my, where I misclicked there. So we need some electrical steel, we've done that before. We need a vibrant capacitor, which means we need vibrant alloys and enderium. I cooked up 1.5 stack of vibrant alloy between episodes, and the emerald electron cube. It's just 5 emeralds in the thermionic fabricator, which we will power by survivalist generator. And the capacitors here, 1 octatic, it's also the machine upgrade. It's what it's like the augments for thermal expansion or the overclocker for IC2. It's your machine upgrade is these capacitors. It makes the machine store more power and also work faster. So 1 octatic requires 2 double layers and 1 ender electron tube, which is endstone and eyes of ender in the thermic fabricator. The endstone is gotten quite easily by putting glowstone inside a stone barrel of lava. And the double layered capacitor is blazing electron tubes and some basic capacitor. I don't know if I made the blazing electron tubes. I think I did. So basically if we take 4 of those, no, 8 of those. Oh, we're out of redstone chipsets. That means we need to put some more redstone in the thing. 2, that's 1 octatic. And we need 4, so that's, we need 8 double layers capacitors. What are we, why, okay. So 1 more, there we go, thank you. So we have half of them, and we need some more redstone in there. So let's take 10 of those. And we could hook up Destine again. And I really hope I remember to actually do the automation of the assembly table today, because that's been bothering me for quite some time. You are not getting dust, that's your problem. I think it's this one. Nope. Nope. Yes. Good. What happens here is, when we run this, the assembly table, these machines, and this setup that does the ores, our power production is not keeping up. So we're at the point where it's time to actually... Why did you fall out? Okay, never mind. We're at the point where it's actually time to also hook up these steam dynamos. I prepared these with the augments that we're going to have in these. These are just energy production modules. And then we have the steam boiler that we crafted in the last episode. We'll hook that up, but first we need somewhere to put the power, and that will be our capacitor bank. Let's see, U3. How many do we need? 4? Maybe. Let's try it. And let's see. There. Now, can we do this? 1. No. Oh my. We're out of signalum as well. This is a sort of a problem. We should get on this problem right now. Now the problem is fixed, and we can now request the final capacitors we needed here. Let's see. What are we missing now? Ah, basic capacitors and basic capacitors. So we have 8 double-layered capacitors. I took the time to also make up a few ender electron cubes, more specifically 40 of them, which should keep us for a while. Vibrant capacitor bank, thank you. This one. Electrical steel and a vibrant crystal. Did I... I've never made the emerald one. I'll do that as well. Let's just place them in here and try to request the rest. And that worked like a charm. Now we have the vibrant crystal. And this can then maybe... Oh, we never made the octatic capacitors. Silly me. So we need 1, 2, 3, 4. No? Good. And these. For electrical steel. And boom! We have the highest tier of energy storage in Ender.io, which stores 25 million RF. And I think the input-output of this one is 25,000 per capacitor. So, where do we want to hook this up? Well, for now, I want to hook it up around here. So if we use this basic one to request kinesis pipes, we want an emerald kinesis pipe, and we want a few golden ones. Let's take 3 of them. Good. Let me take those and place them like this. There, and then this one here. Now, it's quite important. It's, well, semi-important that you don't build this multi-block so it touches this area, because then you'll get a feedback loop and you don't want that. Yes, it's 25,000 RF per tick input-output here. So, now that we can fill this up, we can also then hook it up to charge our jetpacks, for example, once we've made those. And I'm black, so of course I'll go for the dark solarium jet plate. It's basically no different from the thermal expansions redstone flux thingy, but that's golden and no one likes golden, really. No one does. So now we have some proper energy storage for the first time. We can output what was it? I forgot now. Kinesis pipes. 2560 RF per tick per connection of these. So if we expand this way, we put another emerald pipe. No, we move it down and then we put them here. And then we put the golden one above. Because these are one way, just like an iron pipe is when transferring items. Let's see, that's the capacitor bank done. We should hook up the steam dynamos. And we should set up an automation for the laser and also our farm downstairs for crops. Let's meet downstairs by the crops. Okay, so we're down here by the DACF, the DACF. the super autonomous farm. And what we're going to make is epic bacon. And epic bacon takes any, well, cooked pork chop or tofu, which can act as any type of meat. And then 8 dyes. 7, actually, 7 dyes. And those are red, yellow, magenta, green, blue, purple, and orange. The red one we get from the poppies, the yellow one from the dandelions, the magenta from allium, the green one from cactus, and then we have the blue one, that is lapis. There is a seed that we can make for that, and that is the lavender. I'm considering doing it, because we're very much not far off, so we could do that. We can also make seeds for all the other materials that we want, because there's tons of ore crops in this pack. And then we need purple and orange, which are mixes between blue and red, which is lapis and poppy. And then we have the orange, yellow, and red, which is dandelion yellow and rose red. So let's just start by picking this up, and then locking these as well, the drawers. I forgot to do that earlier, I just noticed. And then I've removed some red alloy wire here, because we only have 5 crops now. The red, yellow, magenta, green, and soybean. So those go here, because even if there isn't a crop, the dispenser would dispense bone meal to a crop that isn't there. The first one, cactus, needs to go on sand, so that is fertile and can't grow. And the next one is allium, then dandelion, poppy, and soybean. So if you just try this with this small vanilla comparator clock, let's see what happens. This seems horrible. Okay, let's move this back one, because this is not how it worked when I tried it earlier. Let's see this, and then take some redstone, move that torch. Not only remove, just move like that. Then we have this one, just like that. And you can't be here, you have to be here. So put the lever down. That sounds better. That sounds a lot better. And these don't have power, so they won't pick it up. I forgot about that. Well, the bone milling works, that's for sure. Now these are all set to right click, and they need power to do that. So did I ever install that RF upgrade here? No, I didn't. So if we start by requesting a TE upgrade, this one, that should come in a minute. Now what we're going to make is also conduits. So if we just look for flux ducts, the thermal expansion one, we have the leadstone one, the hardened one. These can transfer 200 RF per tick, 800 RF per tick. This one would be enough. This one would not, because we require 240 RF per tick to go out. This one takes 8,000, and this one takes 32,000. 32,000 we can't even provide via the logistic pipe system, because that one only does 10,000 RF per tick. So let's go for the redstone one, like this. We need a rhodium dust, which require blitz powder, which can be made in the fluid transport with sand and redstone. Well, I finally did something right, and I prepared this. So, 1, 2, and let's see, 1, 2, and 1, 2. So that's requested and done. Now we can do these. Request. Ah, that's 12 of them, that's perfect. Is it? What's jerping? Is it over here? Something's jerping with the crafting of that TE, because that takes way too long. Anyway, this needs to be filled with 200, I believe. Oh! It's easy used to upgrade. I was not aware of that. Yeah, 200 or redstone per. Can also be made in the bottling machine. Interesting. So 200, that's 200, that's 24 redstone. And this is the one I'm using currently. So let's disable this output and enable that one. Can it output to the side of a tank? That would be amazing. And then request the redstone. 24. That would be amazing. It sure can. Then that needs to go in here. Does this have the... It does. Can that pull from that one? Nope. Okay, so we have the destabilized redstone. And we can remove this chest. I don't know what I was thinking when I put this one up for autocrafting. Because this is not how you autocraft with fluid transposers and magma crucibles. But that's okay. Now they are done. Because resonant machines fully upgraded work very quickly. Now, we have that. The TE. Let's see if there's a TE upgrade downstairs. Thermal expansion RF power provider thingy. Let's go this way. Hello, Nico. How are you, Nico? Hi. No. Didn't want to do that. So, if we go down here, is there a there's a crop stick. I'm guessing it should have eaten it and put it into this system if it were to fall down there. If it went into the void, we are screwed. So, I have a cat on my desk. Every once in a while, this one drops items. That's annoying. Really? You have one in the system. I requested one here. This is weird. Let's take this way. It's maybe a bit easier. So, you, let's see. Can take you out and put you here. I believe I prepared that. I didn't. So let's then request a power transfer thingy. That worked. I saw it work. Okay. And I'm a bit afraid now whether this will work or not. That one must have an upgrade. Yes, good. So go upstairs again. Will it work now? Oh yes, that works. So all these should have power. Like this. Here. So that's all 12. In an amazing pattern, so you can go here. No excess, good. And those were harvested immediately. Now for the crucial part. Why are these ejected there? I want to see that with my own eyes. Can't they go into the controller from a golden pipe? That's silly. What happens if we request an item deck? One normal item deck, please. No. Never mind that. I was just being silly. All it needed was to be configured because I locked the drawer so it couldn't put anything in. Now, this is a provider pipe, so that can be accessed from anywhere in the system. So we can easily request those dies later. If we just look at these numbers for maybe 30 seconds or something, we can see that they rise quite quickly, way quicker than they would do with any, well, not any, because if we use the system we have for the wood farm, it would be quicker, but it would take a lot more power. But this is very quick for a simple dye farm, and the soybean as well is getting insanely quickly upwards. And the bone milling Yeah, it keeps up as well. No problem there. And this one is full, as we told it. That's amazing. So the next step would be to craft the dyes we're missing and set up something for the soybeans. So let's do that. I know she made the presses a few episodes ago. Let's just break these. And put her stuff in here. Good. And the presses. We have four because they are nowadays not used in sets of three. They're used in sets of two. A good place to put these would be handy. Let's see, this area does not have power, which means we could set it up right here. So if we try to just, let's make it so they face the right way though. So try setting it up like this, and then let's try a chassis Mark II pipe. I don't know if we have any in the system. If we don't, I want to make them. So, chassis Mark II, one of you, thank you. Then we want a supplier. That's not supplier. We have suppliers in the chest. One supplier and one. Let's see, advanced extraction and extraction at advanced active supplier. Good. That's all the modules I wanted to get, actually, because I want to see if I want have to have the active, no, the advanced extractor, or it's enough with the normal one. So first of all, let's take soybeans. So active supplier, soybean, partial, and let's put in 64. Good. Throw that in there. That should put those in here. Perfect. Good. Now when this is done, we shall put in the extractor and see what it pulls out. It pulls out the soybeans. Let's tell it not to do that by using the advanced extractor. This is included, which is basically a whitelist. Sneaky. So tell it from where to... Oh, that could be it. This one doesn't have sneaky, does it? It does. Let's say down. That works. So all we need is extractors from down, and then some active suppliers that just puts the soybean in. And they don't need to even be Mark II. So let's make four extractor Mark I's and a few active suppliers. Now we have three more Mark II pipes, which means we can have two modules in each. We have some active suppliers. Let's just put them in like two. And then we have the extractors. Let's just put those in there and remove this one. Put in this one instead, and then configure this to pull from down. The active supplier here is soybean. The same thing here, down, and the active supplier, soybean. Let's take a stack like that. This one, however, should also be down, but the active supplier should be soy tofu, silken tofu, I believe. This one. So keep that stocked with the stack of those. Keep that stocked with the stack of those. And extract from down. Perfect. Oh, maybe they should also be partial. Doesn't hurt. Now we're running out of time quickly. That's the downside to recording that for me, because I'm very much not quick. This is actually quicker than the extractor. That means we need a Mark II. That's cool, I guess. Down, good. That's way faster than the presser, so we have a functioning system. awesome. Now we have need somewhere to store the tofu. So, do we have any more marble? Or snow? Let's take a snow block. That's good enough. And let's make a drawer just for the dunned tofu. That's a beautiful drawer. And let's go down here. I'm guessing it's right here. Yes, perfect. Put that there, like that, and key it, like so. Now we have the firm. Woof. Poof. So, all we have to do now is set up some crafting, and we should be able to request the stuff. The what's it called now? Again. Help! What's it called? It's called the Epic Bacon. So let me fix that and we will continue with something else. Now that that's done, we should be able to just request Epic Bacon. So let's do that from here. Ah, all my items in my inventory are in my hotbar is from a logistic pipe, so I might not be able to right click. Anyway, so Epic Bacon. One. Smack. I won't go hungry anymore because this fills up my hunger and my saturation like crazy. These apple juices. I found the perfect home for them. Here you go. Sacrifice to the void. Now, we should do that, but I really want to do this, because this has been annoying me for, like, ever. Let me just tear this down and so we can set it up properly somewhere else. So, what we're going to set up here, if you didn't guess it by now, is automatic laser production stuff in the assembly table. There is an issue with assembly table autocrafting, though. For example, if you're crafting, chipset. Chipset. The iron chipset that takes redstone and iron, and you have to click this one. And then the redstone chipset is only redstone, so if you have them both clicked in, you don't know which one you're going to craft, and if it's multiple, it's going to alternate. So that's bad. So as a solution to that problem, we're going to do. Not that. Let's see. Let's do this. And then the basic pipe. This one. Here. And satellite pipes. The satellite pipes, as usual. We all love the satellite pipe. We should get signs as well. Is it possible that we can have a sign in the system? Let's see. Sign. No, we don't. So let's get planks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of those. And a stick. One of those. Good. That and crafting table. Nope. Crafting table. One of those. No sticks. Okay. Sticks has been derpy lately. Let's see. Let's request two more planks. And the server probably needs a reboot as well. Because some autocrafting is acting up on me. And I didn't like that, so science, good. A good thing to do when you're working with satellite pipes. This one, 12. Thank you. And this one, well, probably 13, I would assume. So 13, good. And the incrementation here is when you press the plus sign, it takes the next available number. So that's convenient. You don't have to remember which ones are taken. And then we also want a 4x3. You and then here. Like that. As you saw there was a ghost item. Because when you place items further than you can reach, that will happen. And as usual, we want a power upgrade. Did I not get the power upgrade? Did I leave that in the requesting table over here? Yes, I did. Thankfully, I didn't lose it. They are not a pain because I have them auto-crafted, but they're annoying to lose because it takes a few items. And then we want the lasers. So that's 1, 2, 3. No. We can also later just make 4 more and put them in the middle to speed everything up. And what will happen with the assembly tables is that they will share the lasers. So if one is using all of them, well, if you're requesting from only one of them, that will take all the lasers. If you're requesting for both of them, they will split up. So you and you. So for example, you in satellite 12, we can get one of you. If we put redstone, that's not redstone. That's redstone. There, in satellite 12. Good. There's my sticks! That's incredibly silly. So, if we just try to request one of you. Let's see what happens. Redstone coming down into that one. Hello? Hello? I can see that you have power through Whale. Don't try to trick me. You can even work through floor, so what's the problem? Oh. Now I'm the derp. As I said before, you have to select which ones you want. So that... Now they should all work. Yeah, that's me derping up for you. That's 280... 320? Let's see, 8 times 4, yes. 320. And if we take another one, this one we'll use satellite 13. We'll make the iron chipset. Here, and let's take iron. And redstone. Whoa, I had it right there. And that's satellite 13. And we put you here. Now if we also request an iron chipset. Shouldn't that redstone chipset come back? Ah, there it is. And this one... I'm guessing this wants to craft something else with iron chipsets, because I didn't request 7. I'm guessing it will provide us with some insight to what it's doing. Yes. Well, that's how that will work. And if we're going to make a more advanced crafting recipe, for example, a machine frame, we will make those as well. We'll use the regular crafting table, or crafting pipe, because the regular crafting pipes can take the upgrades. Where's the upgrade? It's the yellow one, this one. Advanced satellite upgrade. That makes it so they can use more items in the satellite section. However, there is a, well, it has been discussed whether or not this is a bug, but it appears to be a bug because people want to apply those to the modules. If you look to at that one, it can be applied to crafting pipes and crafting modules. That doesn't seem to be the case. It can only be applied to the crafting pipes, and the simplest way to solve that is to put another crafting pipe on some other side of this chest. And if it so happens that we want to have on both of them, we can just spread them apart 1 or 2 blocks more. So this one is working. I wonder where the other iron chipsets are going. Could it be that that's for the TE upgrade that we wanted downstairs? So it's made that now and thrown it on the ground. I would actually hope that it was. There is a spawnable space up here, funnily enough. It's right there. So if anything spawns there, maybe a baby zombie, that would be quite annoying. But that's okay, so because the baby zombie is the only one that can spawn there that could escape that. And hopefully we'll notice it before it kills us. Hopefully. But we need some excitement in our lives. I wonder where that iron ship says is gone. Has gone. You. Shklunk. That's one way to do it. T? No? Iron ship set? No? I'm real curious. I'm really curious. I have requested some stuff. And then it hasn't worked. Oh my. This is another problem altogether. That happens when this runs out. And that is not a good thing. Because then this starts running out and then everything breaks. So... until... we fix some other stuff for power, I'll do this and then I'll put it back once we have more power, and we'll fix that with the steam dynamos finally in the next episode. Thank you so much for watching, and hej då!